Celsius.
The ice spirit climb is quite intense here.
Yeah, we thought it might make you feel a little more at home.
It is quite pleasant.
We're ready to show you those places you remember. Any preference for the order?
Under their current names, the areas are the Kajar Sea Falls, Fenmont, and Fort Gundala.
I'll leave it to you. But just make sure Fort Gundala is last.
Oh, why is that?
You asked if I had a preference, and I answered.
Fort Gundala is a military installation. We should probably ask Rowan to get us permission to visit.
Good idea. I'll give him a call.
In the meantime, let's start by visiting the other two.
Take me to Kijara Sea Falls, or this Fenmont of yours. This is just as I remember it. Cool and relaxing.
So it's always been like this?
They say that couples who stand at the top of the falls develop an intense bond for each other. Daredevil lovebirds used to scramble up there all the time. One man in particular was persistent in inviting me as well. I am a great spirit. I have little interest in participating in human traditions. But I did enjoy watching other humans do it.
I see. It must be an important human custom.
Actually, I've never heard about it.
Then perhaps it's fallen out of practice.
Shall we give it a go?
Yes, why not? And you needn't worry about slipping. Undine will make sure your fall isn't fatal.
Not fatal?
My nostalgia is satisfied. You may do as you please.
All right. Then we'll be back in a jiff, okay?
Are those two always like that? Interesting. It feels like only yesterday that he and I talked here. Has it really been 500 years?
We went all the way to the edge.
Maxwell, I didn't think you'd actually go through with it.
The view was worth the trip alone, and you should have seen Jude.
Mila, I told you to pretend that never happened.
That's right. I quite enjoyed it, to be honest. But if you found it upsetting, I shall suppress the memory.
Well, in that case, you don't have to forget it, but just keep it between us, okay?
Very well. It shall be our secret.
Well, that was certainly fun. On to the next stop. Achoo!
What's wrong? Have you caught a cold?
No, I'm fine. It's just a normal physiological response.
But you were splashed with a significant amount of water back there. I knew I should have...
Mila, it's fine. Honestly, I'm good. I can't tell you that.
Luger's reaction is just so amusing. It's because of the way you're talking, Jude. You're making it sound like we did something scandalous.
Huh? No, it's not that. We didn't do that.
The harder you try to keep it a secret, the more people will wonder. It's basic human nature.
I understand that, but still.
I know. I'll keep my promise. Which means I can't tell you. Sorry about that.
What a strange little city they've built here. There wasn't a building in sight last time I was here. Just an endless field, perfect for watching shooting stars.
Wow, that sounds nice.
People used to say that if you wished upon a shooting star before it vanished, your wish would come true. The human who brought me here loved those silly superstitions. He taught me all sorts of them.
No, Jude is slowly melting the ice around Celsius's heart. I'd only get in the way.
Celsius taught me a 500-year-old method for making wishes come true. Wanna give it a shot?
A spell for granting wishes? Interesting. That does sound like the sort of thing humans would enjoy.
Let's try it.
Here, you move your hands like this while you make your wish.
Intriguing.
Yeah. Did you ever make a wish with anyone back in the day?
I don't recall.
We've made our wishes. Shall we move on?
Just look at this eyesore they built. But this has to be the place. I'd never forget the mana flowing through here.
Why is this place special to you?
Because this is where I met him.
Who?
The first human I ever met. Have you heard of a man named Hao?
That name sounds familiar. Wait, you can't mean Dr. Hao!
Isn't he the head scientist who laid the foundation for spirit arts? If that's the case, his inspiration must have been...
Probably me. We even lived together for a while. He insisted.
We may have just solved one of history's great mysteries.
You could say that.
Dr. Hao's theories spearheaded and eventually led to the fundamental arts of spirit channeling. He laid the entire foundation for the age of spirit arts.
You make it sound like he was some noble historical figure when really he was just a lovesick fool. Always finding an excuse to get close to me, trying everything he could to woo me.
Wait, Dr. Hao... hit on you?
Have all of these locations we visited been places you spent with Hao?
Yes. He used to drag me everywhere, always talking passionately about his dreams for the future. The way most humans do with their friends and lovers. But ultimately, humans and spirits are different creatures. Do you truly believe that spirits and humans can coexist peacefully?
I believe it. In fact, I plan to prove it.
We have vowed to do everything we can to accomplish that goal. Right?
Well then, in that case... I think that we should put your vow to the test.
Why must you remain so stubborn?
Fine by me. Still win.
Tornado Blade! Twin Lance! Dragon the Wound! Here! Torn Impact! Igneous Crush! Judgment Gate!
Won't stop now!
Lightning Strike!
Humans
and spirits
shine bright
as one!
Bronze?
Eternal!
Tiger Blade Sigma!
Hope you don't mind!
Cover me!
Behold my power!
Cover me!
Demon Fist!
Strike force!
Coming assault!
Windlamp!
Swallow dance! Rising falcon!
Strike force!
Windlamp!
Fall!
Swallow dance! Rising falcon! I'm ready!
Windlamp!
Freeze!
Alright!
I hope you don't mind! Sharing is caring!
I'll freeze you to death!
Thanks!
This is the depth of your power.
This is proof of our vow.
I hope you can finally understand. Now I have the strength to protect.
I've grown stronger still.
I've got to get stronger. I know you can do it.
It's still standing. Mila!
I think not.
Ha! Look out! Mila! Are you okay?
Jude, why would you do this?
I just can't stand seeing you hurt. I wouldn't do this for just anyone, you know? Don't you see that?
Jude, you idiot.
Just look at them. Let me tell you, that idiot right there is every bit the fool Hal was. Jude, Maxwell, you might be able to accomplish our vision. You have what it takes to go and finally create the world that Hal and I always dreamed of.
Yeah. Sorry about that. Celsius.
We never got to talk with her about anything besides her memories.
It doesn't matter. Celsius and Dr. Howe have given me the lead I needed. This might be the key to resuming my Spyrite research. Baylan, it's Jude. I may have found a way to complete the Spyrite project.
What? Seriously?
Yeah. It'll take a while to explain, though.
First things first, Jude. You need to get your wounds treated before telling any long stories.
Okay. Maybe we can borrow Dracel's manor in Sherrilton.
Such foolishness. This really makes me question your priorities, Jude.
Huh? Are you mad at me?
What a nice breeze. I could spend all day here.
Hold still. I can't treat your wounds if you keep squirming.
I told you, I'm fine. I already gave myself first aid.
Now.
Let's hear your breakthrough for the Spyrite project.
No, maybe this isn't a good time.
Baylan, thanks for coming.
Wild wyverns couldn't have kept me away. Now, what's this revelation of yours?
Well, Spyrites are essentially just spirits, right? Even once they become Spyrites, they still have their own minds. So instead of trying to control them, we should be asking for their cooperation.
Asking for their cooperation? How exactly?
That's the thing. It's the same way Rizemaxians do it every day. You figured it out too.
Ah, yes. The process in which spirits perform arts for humans in exchange for our mana. It presumably requires some form of communication to form a contract.
So, spirit arts are actually a conversation of sorts.
Dr. Howe was originally trying to communicate with spirits when he invented spirit arts. It must be that the arts contain within them a message that's sent to the spirit.
You're right! We picked up on some incomprehensible system of signals when we were analyzing the spirit arts process. If it turns out to be an encrypted spirit language, it just might be what we're looking for.
If we decode it and apply it to Spyrites,
we'll even be able to make requests of the great spirits. Can you imagine that?
I'll analyze the signals immediately. Leave everything to me.
Hey, impressive work there.
I didn't do anything. It's all thanks to Celsius.
You inherited the possibilities that Howe once envisioned, and that will be the key in leading us to a brighter future. You humans really are something.
Thank you for everything. I will make sure that your dream comes true. I feel like we could take down anything when we're together. We've been through some tough times, and I don't know if I could have made it through them without your support. I'm sorry I don't know a more elegant way to express this, but thank you. I'm grateful for all that you've done, and I'm proud to call you my friend.
Thank you. Hello, hello! Nova here! Got big news about your next job.
Sorry, Nova. Luger's tied up at the moment.
What? Hey, wait a minute!
Just tracked him down. Yep, we'll be right over. Just hang tight.
They want us to hurry?
Pretty much. Luger, you've been such a big help to us. It's only fair you come see our big announcement. No, let's call it a celebration. I knew you'd pick up what I was putting down.
And as the only journalist invited, I'll be coming along to document the whole thing.
We expect big things from you, Snoops. We've booked the bar in Duval, so we better get moving.
Duval? Way over there? I thought I'd be rubbing shoulders with a who's who of Shandu.
I'm not made of moolah. Believe me, I checked out some of the options. My wallet hurts just thinking about it.
Ouch. Alrighty. But you owe me one, okay? Better start saving.
Fair enough. Let's just call this the pre-party. Hey, you started without me.
Well, you never said not to. Right?
Balin was telling me about the time you two went drinking.
What?
What's the story?
Let's just say it involves a sloppy young Alfred and a humiliating confession.
Never happened. Stop making stuff up.
Excuse me, can I get anyone a drink?
An apple juice, please.
Whatever they're having. You? Yeah, that's the spirit, buddy. Ahem. I'll start with the big news. We need to unload all the merchandise we've been planning to sell to you-know-who.
Huh?
You okay with this?
Apparently, it's just how you break into the business world in Olympias.
Exactly right. Going after them now wouldn't accomplish anything at this point. Hate to get a bad reputation by making a big deal out of this and losing.
Huh. Because that would just make things worse.
Fortunately, we're not alone. Balin had our back on this one.
I know some people.
So you taking that job they offered?
Turned him down. I'm business partners with Jürgen now. There's absolutely no way I'm just tossing that away.
Very well said. I mean, you even came to me for help.
Hey, so are you really okay with this?
We talked this over already. It's all good. I'm fine.
I really am glad I got into business with you. Thank you. This was a real learning experience for me. I'm not the world's best businessman. It's pretty clear that I need someone like you around.
Come on. I wouldn't even have known where to start without you.
Listen to that. They're the perfect team.
Yeah.
There's no need to patronize us.
The perfect team, huh? Gotta say, I'm looking forward to the future.
Oh, final question. So, the two of you got into business to build a bridge between the two nations. And do you still think that's possible at this point?
The two countries certainly have radically different values, but that just makes for a challenge worth meeting.
Sometimes there's more important things in business than simple profit. Now that I've finally learned that lesson, I'd like to try my luck at it again.
I think I have the makings of a great story here.
Looks like everyone's all set.
From the top?
Okay, let's do this.
Cheers!
Thanks, pal, for all your help. It feels like we've been fighting together for as long as I can remember. I guess it's a little funny for me to say this now after all that's happened, but I want you to keep moving ahead. Whatever future you're putting your chips on, I'm in. You just keep looking forward, because I've got your back.
That's a nice breeze. I could stand here all day.
Hey, I just arrived myself.
You guys worried about Kyle too?
It's been a while since I heard anything from him. I only hope this dread I'm feeling is just my imagination.
They're here.
Good day, Erston. I'd offer you a drink, but we're in the middle of an interrogation here. Not that you seem to care.
Tanner, Kyle, are you unhurt?
They just grabbed us out of the blue.
Kyle.
You beat up these children?
Oh, please. It's not that bad. We simply taught these punks to respect the law. After all, they were obstructing a murder investigation.
What?
Plenty of witnesses were there. They all saw what happened. They watched Kyle shove and kill that soldier.
No way.
I blew it, Big E. But that soldier started it. He was harassing me even though I didn't do squat. He treated me like a criminal.
That Reza Maxian started the whole thing!
I'm sorry, Big E. I'm so sorry.
I'm not the one you need to apologize to.
Oh, that reminds me, Erston. There are some folks I would like for you to meet. Hey, let them in. I'm so sorry. You have my deepest condolences.
Huh?
This man and woman are none other than the grieving parents of the murdered Reza Maxian soldier.
Is this the kid who killed my son, Detective?
Allegedly. The case isn't closed yet.
Tell me why. Why did you do it? Why did you kill our son?
So, what do you think? Do you still insist on protecting this man, Erston? It can't be easy when one of the subjects you've sworn to protect wails for her dead son.
Huh? What are you talking about?
Open your eyes. This man is no run-of-the-mill Reza Maxian. He is King Gaius of Reza Maxia. Huh. Did you really think he was some Joe Schmo in your little gang?
Vicky? Come on, say it ain't so.
Yeah.
He's right.
Huh?
The scene of the crime was Marksburg, which is under the joint jurisdiction of both countries. That means Reza Maxia is in a unique position to demand custody of the suspect.
Is that true?
I could do that, however.
However? That sort of thing would cause one heck of an international incident, I bet. The Risa Maxians would be up in arms and out for blood over the incident. It might even poison the current negotiations on tariff autonomy that are so very important to Risa Maxia.
I know.
Biggie.
Just think about it, Kyle. Who do you really believe is on your side here? The Risa Maxian king who's been pretending to be your friend this whole time? Or me, a fellow Olympian?
I don't know what to tell you.
Take me with you. I'll talk.
Your Majesty, my boss's boss's boss is waiting at the Marksburg Inn. If you'd be so kind as to come and meet with my superior, I'm sure the both of you could discuss more than a few words in private.
With Risa Maxia's cabinet ministers, I imagine.
Yes, exactly. You imagine right.
Caius.
I know. It's true I could use my powers to protect Kyle from prosecution, but then I would fail as a king. I wouldn't be able to face my people. Let's discuss this at the hotel. We should return there immediately.
Thank you for waiting, Your Majesty. Everyone is assembled in the conference room. If you would follow me, please.
Luger, what are your thoughts on Kyle's crime? Make it sound so simple. Such clarity comes from having a strong sense of morality. You've helped me accept what I must do, and I am grateful for it.
What will happen to Kyle?
I agreed to extradite him to Olympias.
Did you win a concession on the tariffs in return?
The ministers are thrilled. They said the life of one soldier was a small price to pay. In my position, personal feelings are irrelevant. Were I just a normal friend, perhaps I might have tried to save Kyle from being arrested.
That must have been hard.
It is my duty.
Wise decision, Your Majesty. You allowed Olympias to save face, but it also brought a great boon to your people. To be completely honest, I didn't think you had it in you. I wish I were as good at my job as you are. Well then, I'll be off. Until next time.
I would have preferred it if he were openly insulting.
Olympias is the one that holds the upper hand when it comes to negotiations between the two countries. That man probably set this whole thing up. He knew full well I wouldn't act against the interests of Risa Maxia. Pardon me. Would you mind throwing this away for me?
Are you sure, sir?
Yes. It was a gift for a man named Erston, a gift from his friends. I have no right keeping it.
But it's proof that you had any friends at all. People who actually wanted to spend time with you. As a normal man, as Erston. I think that humans and spirits alike all need people who will accept them for who they truly are.
What'll it be?
I'll hold on to it. Luger, let's have a group photo sometime. You, me, and all the others.
The job postings sure are beneficial. Why, we could put in requests for all the world's finest foods. But then, I guess we'd have to offer a suitable reward for each one.
I was contemplating your existence and what it means to me. I am Gaius, and I am Erston. I have two faces and two identities. But whatever my guise, be it commoner or king, I feel that you're somehow able to bring out the true me. You are not my enemy, nor my subordinate. It pleases me to consider you my friend. Perhaps I have said too much, or perhaps there is nothing wrong with saying this sort of thing from time to time.
Thank you.